we always say, Matt, that the Adrenaline Championship is the most exciting title in British wrestling. We stand by that. And virtually every single match that is ever put on by that champion holds that to be true. And what it's given us in the last few months is one of the hottest and most fiercest rivalries in British wrestling right now.
Yeah, these two men, these two lifelong friends turned bitter, bitter rivals, have been going to war over the last few months. And here he comes, pound for pound, the best in the Northwest, that man CJ Banks.
He's been gunning for the Adrenaline title for months, and he's just been unable to get his hands on it. His first match with Joey Hayes for the belt ended in a time limit draw. The rematch ended in a double pinfall. Both men's shoulders were on the canvas for three. The third match was a triple threat contest involving Chris Ridgeway. And in that match, Joey Hayes tapped out Chris Ridgeway. So Banks has been unable to claim the title. And Joey Hayes has been time and time again unable to put that man away.
Well, tonight's the perfect opportunity to have a decisive winner in this 2 out of 3 falls match.
Mr. Futureshock himself, Mr. Adrenaline Champion, Joey Hayes, not just popular in this part of the world, a folk hero right here. And we see that each and every time he comes out. And he has been, since day one, one of the absolute best in this company. He's put away challenger after challenger. He's put away rival after rival.
Apart from that man that stood in front of him. And we know Joey and his history with his championship belt. The first time he ever won a major championship was the Adrenaline title here in Futureshock. Had it cruelly ripped away from him. Regained that championship. And now what he finds in front of him is this roadblock. And not only is it a roadblock, but it's someone that he has such a close history with. And you've got to think that he's driving both men insane.
The first contest was a hold-for-hold Matt Classic. The second was a bitter slugfest. That triple threat match was out of the world and had so many combustible elements. We just don't know what we're going to see next, Matt. The referee checking under orders. What it's all about, the Adrenaline title.
And I don't know if you noticed there, Rob, that title put in the center of the ring, almost marking the line for CJ Banks, saying if you want this championship, you've got to be able to take that step up.
Do you think it has become, between these two men, about more than that title?
I don't think I know. I know these two better than arguably anyone else on this roster, maybe aside from Sam Bailey and Danny Hope. And I, you know, we've been friends a long time, but there is always rivalries within them friendships. I mentioned in the previous contest, they're the former tag team partners. But the problem is the first person that ever taught us how to wrestle was Joey Hayes. Me and CJ Banks walked into that school, and he was the person that told us the basics. And ever since that moment, I watched CJ Banks look at Joey Hayes and was so desperate not only to be on Joey's level, but be better than Joey.
Well, to take the title tonight, CJ Banks must be better than Joey, not just once, but twice.
And this is what I find quite interesting. I think that this rule set kind of goes into the favour of Banks, this two sort of falls to a finish, I guess, is that almost that old British style. These are the kind of wrestlers that brought CJ Banks through, the James Masons, the Robbie Dynamites, the Mikey Whiplashes, the Robbie Brooksides. He is well-versed within that old British style and well-versed in the art of pacing and wrestling match.
We're seeing a pace very similar to their first encounter, part of our last stand at the old Guild Hall. CJ Banks getting that shoulders down, look at that. Joey Hayes has really got to lift himself out of that position. There we go. Back, right back down to it.
You know, you mentioned the Guild Hall sort of being that iconic venue, but correct me if I'm wrong, but didn't Joey Hayes win his first adrenaline title in this very building?
Back down to it, you are absolutely correct. You put away Wolfgang here at Uproar 100.
You know, and you've got to feel that, like, Joey has a bit of confidence in that. You know, I remember that iconic photo.
Over the cross, Hayes. Oh, going. Looking for it well early. And that is a lethal, lethal finishing hold that Joey Hayes has perfected.
Oh, look for that Tiger Driver.
Shoulders are down. And again, both these men trying to get the upper hand. Over and over they go. Trading one counts. Joey. Maybe this one, no.
Oh, straight into the cross, Hayes, though.
You're right, getting that locked in, and CJ Banks grabbing that bottom rope, pulling himself out.
And I mentioned pace. Look at the pace of this opening contest. Go back to that match they had. It tapped a very slow, methodical pace, almost under the control of CJ Banks. Fast forward to that triple threat they had with Chris Ridgeway. Incredibly frantic match. And straight here in the early goings, that frantic pace, that first decision in this match is so important.
Why is that, Matt? It's not just for getting one on the board.
It's psychological. It's the fact that you know you can beat your opponent straight away. It's almost like that confidence boost that you have for the next sort of fall that you need.
Joey Hayes will always have the support of the fans right here in Futureshock. And let's not ignore what that can do for a performer as you get into the second round, as you get into the third round perhaps. And look at CJ Banks just lighting Joey Hayes up with these blows. And that's what we saw in their second contest, that slugfest between them.
Yeah, almost that SBT street fight style, but Joey exchanging shots here.
Banks floors him, hits the ropes, builds momentum. Saw that coming, avoided again. As we've said, as Matt said, they know each other so well. They know each other's styles, they know each other's attack. And perhaps they even know how each other are going to think.
Oh.
What an uppercut. Unreal. And Joey Hayes just crumpled.
And if you just look at the demeanour of Banks, it's that of confidence that hits that uppercut, takes his time to get Hayes back up.
My word.
You know, it's such a great point about knowing each other. It's one thing knowing a guy that you've wrestled numerous times, but a guy that you have teamed with numerous times. You know habits and tricks that they don't even know that they do.
Banks controlling this on the outside. It's important to remember that the 10 count outside the ring still in effect for these rounds. This is not going to be an out and out brawl all over the building. Oh my! And that knee came down so hard into Joey Hayes. Banks is fully, and I mean fully, in control in this first round. We said the first round is perhaps the most important round, the pace setter. My word. A stomp right down onto the hands, the fingers, and if the fingers are taken out of commission, there's so limited.
And he doesn't have the fingers, no cross haze, he can't lock in that butcher's hook that he needs to employ it. But the thing as well in this early round is that you want to put some damage on your opponent as well. There's one thing to be said about getting that quick, decisive fall as quickly as possible, but you've got to think, it's almost a game of chess here, it's the human game of chess. You've got to think 2-3 steps ahead.
We talked in the Grodd T-Bone match about money in the bank, working the body, pulverizing the body so that it pays off later in the competition. And that is something, certainly something that I think both men are going to want to try and put in. And certainly CJ Banks has already decided to put in.
Here comes Hayes. Oh,
my word. Oh. And that blistering pace of Joey Hayes came to a crashing dead end.
And this is almost a mirror image of the match that they had at TAP, that slow, methodical pace. And I said during that match, Joey needs separation. The minute Joey gets separation, he gets to sort of go through the gears and up the speed.
Knee to the solar plexus. Wow, there we go. Oof. He gets all the purchase on that snap.
I can tell you now for a fact that is the most painful snap suplex I have ever taken in wrestling.
And remember, folks, with every submission hold you see, with every near fall you see, with every impact you see, this is just the first round. This has got to keep going until we have a definitive winner of 2 entire rounds. Joey Hayes did very well to get out of that one. And now Joey Hayes is trying to control the pace and control the momentum with those big right hands of his. And CJ Banks is covering up in the corner, and that is not doing him any good as Joey goes to the boots. And CJ Banks getting strips torn out of him here. Oh no. And look at this, almost exactly as what we talked about in that Grodd match. Working the pulverizing the body.
Yeah, and I think Joey got caught there by sort of going into the fight that CJ wanted, but there we go.
Look at that crash collision in the corner.
As much as a great striker Joey is, I really don't think he wants to get into a fist fight with Banks. If I'm Hayes, I'd want to be going for more of a wrestling match, trying to either catch him off guard or get in that cross haze, which we've seen is so effective.
I think you're right that the methodical pace that we saw in the first match seems to suit CJ Banks. Joey Hayes wants to go for a wrestling match that gives him the opportunity to fire out with his explosive weapons that he's got in his arsenal. The JKO, the OKJ. Those big moves that can put some real, real damage on the opponent. And in the corner now, Hayes really bringing it.
And maybe... I don't think it's frustration, but I think it's determination to prove he can hang in there with Banks with this.
Oh, look at that. I think Joey Hayes suckered CJ Banks in. Calling for one more time. He knew Banks was going to come for him, and he was ready and waiting. But perhaps it didn't last long enough. No. Drops down behind. Ripcord. Oh, my. The OKJ. That reverse cut of that neck breaker, and is this not enough?
And there's that first major move for Hayes, though, on the neck of Banks. You know, you said that he likes to use the JKO as well as the cross haze, all that pressure on the neck. And then there's someone like CJ Banks that wrestles the schedule that he wrestles, almost wrestling 7 times a week. You know there is damage over and over again to that neck region.
Kicks the leg right out from under him. To the second rope. My word, what an uppercut. CJ Banks firing himself off that turnbuckle like a bullet, and look at this.
Tiger driver.
Shoulders are down, hooked.
Oh!
How firmly Banks had his feet placed on top of the arms to keep the shoulders down. really thought that was going to be the first fall, and that kick out looks like it is just really angered CJ Banks.
It was almost like a desperation at first that turned into pure anger.
Well, that's what we've seen in all these encounters. Every time he's been unable to beat Joey Hayes, the rage has come firing out of CJ Banks. He has snapped again and again.
And as someone who's been on the receiving end of CJ Banks snapping, whether that be in school when we were 10 years old and he decided to kick my head in, or in professional wrestling when he decided to turn his back on me, that rage has always been there. He's got a temper.
To the corner, rolling through. Joey's shoulders are down, shoulders are down.
Oh,
face first into that buckle.
JKO!
JKO! Is this, can he get him over? Can he get him over? All the advantage now lies with Joey Hayes as he takes the first fall decisively, Matt, nailing CJ Banks with the JKO, right spark in the middle of that ring.
And months of frustration of questioning can he beat CJ Banks is out of his mind now. He's done it once, he just needs to do it one more time.
That is the first time, you're right, in all these months that Joey Hayes has been able to get a three count on CJ Banks. And here we go, rest period over. Going for it again. No, avoided that time. Oh, and the referee didn't see that boot, that blatant boot right between the legs. The knee pads down, the knee pads down.
Oh, bazooka knee from Banks.
Catches him flush in the middle. And just like that, CJ Banks manages to even the score.
Well, you know, we've seen CJ Banks be, shall we say, unsportsmanlike in the conduct that he's, and the way he's treated Joey, but there is, gave him the advantage, and you can see that the minute he knew he had Joey in trouble, he pulled down that knee pad and hit that bazooka knee.
I gotta think the minute he knew he had given up a fall.
Look, he's going to get, he's stalking him again, Rob. The minute that bell goes, you know exactly what Banks is looking for.
The referee has got to make sure that Joey's back on his feet before he calls an end to the rest period and rings the bell. And if Joey can't answer that call, that's going to be it. We're going to have a new champion.
Oh, look at Banks just standing over
his
prey.
Well, this is not on, Matt. There's a rest period for a reason. There's got to be separation here. There's got to be separation. CJ Banks is really abusing the rules. Oh! JKO! A low angle JKO!
There's the bell!
Last period is over! Rolls him over! Oh!
Cross A's though, straight into that cross A's!
Wrenching, tearing, that lethal, lethal cross A's! That has tapped out competitor after competitor. And CJ Banks is like an animal, a wounded animal in a trap, and he is fighting for everything he can to escape a deadly hold. Rolling out didn't help. Biting and gnawing and chewing on the hands. Like a trapped, caged animal, CJ Banks became rabid there.
Banks escaping by the literal skin of his teeth.
And Joey Hayes' hand was just mauled in the mouth of CJ Banks.
And here we go.
And these two men want the win here and want that belt so much. Into the corner. And Hayes' hand is really bothering him here. Lifts Banks up onto the turnbuckle. Joey Hayes is looking for one big full stop on this. No, CJ Banks gets himself free with that vicious headbutt. What on earth are these two men willing to do to each other? to get the victory, to walk out with that title tonight. Oh, a superplex. Both shoulders. Oh no, not again. Not again.
Oh.
And that was exactly how things went in the second encounter. Both men's shoulders were down. And these two men exhausted from two falls so far. The referee count in effect. One fall apiece as they go nose to nose, head to head. And you've got to think, in this kind of physical, violent encounter, this kind of slugfest, you've got to give the advantage to CJ Banks.
But that man is giving all he can in this exchange. Oh!
And these shots reverberating through the town hall here. Battling on their knees here. And these uppercuts are absolutely rocking Joey Hayes. And this might be the end of his title reign, because I don't know how much more of this punishment he can take, Matt.
Well, he looks like he wants some more. Just beckoning Banks in, but
asking him, do you want more? Dodged it. Enzu Giri. Joey Hayes coming alive here. At Uproar 105, he is feeling it. He is getting primed and ready. Oh,
oh!
Right into that German suplex throw. Oh, one more time. Is this the last fall? Into the cross haze. Into the cross haze. And he's tapped it out. He's tapped out. Falls going to that man, going to Joey Hayes. The rivalry that has consumed the adrenaline title in this year, Matt, in 2019. The rivalry that has lit up show after show. Joey Hayes has finally beaten CJ Banks.
Oh, Joey Hayes vanquishes one of his enemies and ejects him from his house. Joey Hayes is absolutely one of the pillars of the Northwest wrestling scene, and that championship in his hands only confirms that.
What a rivalry. What a feud. What competition between these two men. I don't know what Joey was looking for there. Maybe a mark of respect, maybe a come together moment, but Banks is certainly not going to give it to him. Well, CJ Banks has got his head held low as Joey Hayes gets his arm raised high. It was a hell of a series of matches. Two out of three falls.